On today's Matt's Minutes, let's talk about the new Kreg K5 system of pocket hole joinery. So it's no secret that I've been using pocket hole joinery in the basement workshop for quite a while now, and I've had the opportunity to try out a number of the Kreg pocket hole systems. In fact, up until just recently, we were using the K4 system, which is a really, really solid system. I highly recommend it to anybody if you happen to come across one and you want to get into pocket hole joinery, or you want to upgrade maybe the existing pocket hole joinery that you're using. It's a really, really solid system and it works fantastic. Just recently, the folks over at Kreg sent us a K5 version, which is the latest version they have out right now. And I have to tell you, after using it, I definitely really, really like this system for a number of reasons, as I see them as improvements over the K4. Number one, just let's first look at the bodies here. You can see that the K5 is definitely wider than the K4. So it's nice to have that solid footprint. In fact, it's about 1.5 the times size of the K4. And again, that's really nice to have that solid footprint. It's kind of neat because they also include these wings that just slide right into these dovetailed ways, which helps to expand this. So say I have a piece that's kind of a longer one and I want to maybe do my pocket hole joinery so that it's going to attach like almost like a long grain to long grain joint. It's nice to have that support so it's not just here at the center. Again, that extra support really kind of helps out in certain situations. Of course, you don't need it, and if you don't need it, you just simply kind of get these out of the way. I should mention that these also double as storage space, so you could say have screws in one, and in my situation, I also happen to have all the hardware, including the drill bit and the steps and everything else, and we'll talk about those in just one second here. Let's compare the K4 and the K5, again, some improvements that I really like from it. Number one, I like the cam action, the improvement on this, on the K5 itself. As you can see, in this particular situation with the K4, the cam action is on the back side, which really isn't a big deal. It works out pretty fine, except of course, maybe if you have a really wide piece, in that case, you gotta kinda come around and grab it. In this situation, the K5, it's here on the front. So it's really nice because then all the action is right here. I don't have to worry about it. When it comes to the actual clamping mechanism, we can see, and I'll try to get a close up here of both of these so that you can really get the comparison. On the K4, it's this little tiny one, not really that tiny, but at the same time, depending on the material you're working with, it could maybe just have like a small area where it's not clamping it completely. On the K5 itself, you can see that it has this nice big faceplate right here for the clamping action. Another one is, say, depending on the thickness of the material we're working with, you want, of course, get this as close up here so that when you do engage it, it's going to be nice and tight. This is just simply a matter of pushing a button in, and it slides back and forth to the desired thickness. On the K4, you have to move this this nut, and then you just simply move this around until you get it to that desired width, or thickness, excuse me. So obviously the K5, this happens a lot faster. Now, when it comes to the drill guide itself, on the K4, you have this knurled nut here that you have to end up screwing in and out. And on each one of the drill guides, there's these preset holes that correspond with the thickness of the material that you're gonna be drilling into. And so it's a matter of, one, getting it set up on the side here, but then you gotta try and line up those holes and you hope you get it just the right way, because occasionally I have actually started to tighten this knurled knob and damage one of these holes on the drill guide. With the K5, rather than having a knurled knob, we just simply have a pull button or a little pull piece here, and you can kinda, you can feel when it's in place so you're not damaging those, and it works really easily and it holds really tight. Again, I've already used this and it stayed really, really snug with how I wanted it in place. Now, one thing I will say that I kind of wish they had stuck to this with the previous one, and actually it's not that big of a deal because I can just swap these out, get some of that sawdust out of there. We can see when it comes to the measurements for the thickness of the material we're working with, this is a printed version on the new one, and on the other one, it's actually indented. It's right into the material itself. This is really nice. I prefer to have this simply because of the fact that as I use this, it's very possible to wear much of that off. But the cool thing is, Just like with all of the Kreg products, these are all made to be interchangeable, so I could just take this older one, drop it right in, and I'm good to go. In fact, I can drop that one over into here, so I still get all the advantages, oh, it's on this side, of the way that I like these markings. Speaking of being able to swap things in and out, of course, you can do the same thing with any of the previous versions of these drill guides you have. This happens to be the micro one, so again, I can kind of drop these in and out of there. One that just came in, and I haven't had a chance to use it because I don't use a lot of big, thick material. You can see that this is like the Kreg, I think they call this the HD. This is a drill guide for working with, say, like 2x4s or really, really thick boards that you're going to be working with. And again, there we go. You can drop this right into here, and it has a hole that will engage it so that you have it exactly at the thickness that you need. And again, you can do all your pocket hole joinery with this. Now, let's talk about actually the dust collection on this, because believe it or not, these do have dust collection. With the K4, we have this one piece. It has the hose attachment going in one single direction, so depending on where you are, you always have to have it going off to that side. Here on the new K5, obviously we can see that this swivels, so that again gives you just that many more opportunities to use it wherever you need it. And when it comes down to it, that is really the main things that really kind of are an improvement over one from the other. An important key to getting good results from pocket hole joinery is making sure that, number one, you use the correct screw. And in order to use the correct screw, you have to make sure that the holes that you're creating are at the appropriate depth for that screw. Early on, it seemed like in order to set up the stop collar for the blade or for the drill bits, you had to kind of use maybe a homemade jig. And then when the K4 came along, it was really nice because they have kind of this indented area that you can, say, drop the bit down into, and then there's these nice preset marks on here that you find the appropriate size screw that you want to use, and then you put the stop collar in place, and there we go. Come in with your Allen wrench, and you can tighten it, and now you're ready to go because you know you have it at the appropriate length. With the K5 system, they came up with another version of it, and I really kind of like this one, although it means that I could potentially lose this neat little guide they have here, but at the same time, it's just a matter of dropping it into the wing and making sure that I keep it safe. They have this little guide set up with the screw lengths that you're going to end up using. You put it into place here, and let's just loosen this up again real quick here so we can get a good example of it. You then drop your drill bit in, and it fits right into the appropriate hole. It is now set for the length that you need for, again, the appropriate screw. You come in, you tighten it, and you're ready to go. Just drop this right back in, out of way, and you're all set. And that's all there is to the K5 system. Again, there's some really nice improvements on here that I absolutely love compared to the previous versions. I'm excited to see what they're coming out with next. Who knows, maybe some sort of laser engagement on here. That would be really cool. But the nice thing is, regardless of which Kreg system you go with, they all are pretty much interchangeable. They work with each other, whether it's something like the micro all the way up to the extra large HD kind of a thing. They really give you great results. The main thing is to use the appropriate screw for the application that you're planning on using the pocket hole system with. And with that said, if you have any comments, questions, suggestions, you know how to get a hold of me. You can email me at mattsbasementworkshop@gmail.com. Of course, you can leave a comment in the show notes for today's episode over at mattsbasementworkshop.com. And you know what? I think I've got a couple of things that I want to try this out on a little bit more because, well, it's just a really fun system. So until the next time, straight grains and sharp blades. Take care, everybody.